Be seated. We'd like to thank everyone for being here this afternoon on this joyous time for us as our kids have come to be joined today in matrimony. And we just certainly welcome every one of you and ask that you all just make yourself at home and be comfortable in our evening. We've got a long evening ahead of us. Hope that you can all stay. At this moment, I have to ask that if there be anyone here today that can show any just cause as to why these two should not be married today, then you should speak now or forever hold your peace. I'd like to ask at this time, is this woman to this man?
Thank you.
Marriage is God's first institution, and it's for the welfare of the race. And in the quiet bowers of Eden, before the tempter had touched the fruits, God ordained it and said that marriage was good. He said that man should leave mother and cleave to his wife, and the two of them together should become as one. It's originated in divine wisdom and in goodness, designed to promote happiness and holiness. This rite is the foundation of home, life, and social order, and it must so remain till the end of time. It was sanctioned and honored by the presence and the power of Jesus at the marriage in Cana of Galilee, and marked the beginning of his wondrous works. It is declared by the apostles to be honorable in all things. So it is ordained today that, Jeremy, you shall leave father and mother. You shall become one flesh with Tori, united in hopes and aims and sentiments, in all the interest of the present time. Jeremy, today, do you and Tori have any reason why you should not be joined today? And it is your desire to proceed. Jeremy, you've taken the woman that you hold by the right hand to be your lawful and wedded wife. Before God and the witnesses present, you must promise to love her, to honor her, and to cherish her in this relationship. And leaving all others, Jeremy, you must cleave only unto her, and be to her in all things a true and a faithful husband, so long as you both shall live. Jeremy, do you so promise? You, Tori, in taking this man that you hold by the right hand to be your lawful and wedded husband before God and these witnesses present, you must also promise to love him, honor him, and cherish him in your relation. Leaving all others, you must cleave only unto him, and be to him in all things a true and a faithful wife, so long as you both shall live. So are you so promised? Before we share in the exchange of the rings this evening, I'd like to say this to the two of you. The vows that you're taking are promises to each other. The promise of love, the promise of honor. You're also making promises before God in heaven that you're going to allow these rules to remain in your home, that you're going to be true and faithful to each other, that you will hold one another in times of fear, you will comfort each other when you're sick, you'll be there for each other when you're weak. You're agreeing to those things today. You accept those things. I'd like to ask you today what token of love you have. As you look at your rings there for a moment, I'd like for you to just look at the unbroken circle. There is a promise of an unbroken circle in this bond, in this marriage today. I promise you, Jerry and Tori, that when hard times come, troubles come, you're going to have doubts as to whether this marriage was right. You're going to see days to where you think, why did I do it? You're going to see hard times come. It may be financial, it may be other problems, but these rings that you exchange today will always be a reminder to you of the vows that you took. It's round, it's unbroken, so should your vows be unbroken. Again, you share your lives together with one another and share your hopes and sentiments with one another. And today, as a reminder, your ring, unbroken. No cuts, unbroken, whole, one piece. Jeremy, in taking the ring and placing it on her left hand, just for you guys. Repeat after me, please. With this ring, I be wed with loyal love. I be endowed in all my worldly goods. With thee I share. And with the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost. Lord, placing the ring upon his left hand, will be after me. With this ring, I be wed with loyal love. I be endowed in all my worldly goods. With thee I share. In the name of the Father, the Son. Thank you. Chaplain has chosen this afternoon to light the unity candles, and the substance behind lighting the candles means that they are giving up as two and becoming as one. The mothers lighting the candles today represents them giving freely their children to one another. So we want you to join with us. I believe we have a song for this occasion, and as they light the unity candles, please be peaceful and reverent to them. Blesses this wedding today, and I'd like for you, if you would, to bow for just a moment and let's ask thank you so much for this opportunity as we stand before you. Lord, we humbly do thy job that you've given us and commissioned us to do today as we bring these two together as husband and wife. We pray, Father, that you honor this wedding the same as you did in Cana. We'd ask that you bless and anoint this wedding, that bless this couple as they've come together. That they forever keep you in their minds and in their hearts. And Father, when the blessing of children come, that they'll bring those children up in a Christian manner and in a godly home. Father, that they'll always stand beside each other, and they'll stand with you too. We ask you to ordain this and bless the families today. Lord, as not just the couple comes together, but the families become together too today and join in these sentiments together. We ask thy blessings upon each one that has come to be here with us today. Be with us and keep us safe, Lord, for these next time. We pray and we thank you. In the name of our sweet Jesus, amen. I'd like to pronounce the couple today as husband and wife, and Jeremy and Tori, as they become Mr. and Mrs. Jeremy McNutt. You may kiss your beautiful bride.
Take pictures of each other taking pictures, and I'll film you. I'll record you taking pictures of each other's taking pictures.
Hey, you know me.
Come on.
He's not happy about it.
Yeah.
Henry Ford.
My name is Arnold.
No, I'm just going to say whatever I did.
I'm glad to see Jeremy and Corey here. Big feet, he can move them too.